So I gotta tell you, today is a momentous occasion, you know why? This is the first time I've ever performed comedy where I haven't been the only person at the night performing comedy. So, I know, usually it's a very lonely world in the stand-up, but tonight, everyone's doing so great tonight, and I just want to thank the SPAC people for putting this on. So, can you guys give a round of applause to them? Yeah, that crowd interaction gets you on my side. It's a psychological thing to make you more likely to laugh. All right. Okay. So, I was a little nervous coming out here tonight because they told me I had to be under 5 minutes. But then I was trying to organize my material to be under 5 minutes, get my best five. But then I saw in the email that I also had to not have any offensive material, so that made it a lot easier to trim down. I'm just kidding, I don't have any offensive material. I mean, like, I could make fun of Donald Trump, but I'm not gonna do that tonight. It's too easy. Actually, you know, I do have one weird joke. It's not offensive, but it's about my friend Corey, and he has one arm. And it's not like, lend me a hand. It's not that kind of joke. But I'm gonna come back to it later, because... You guys, okay. I'm gonna come back to it later, because I have a lot of stuff. Well, not a lot of stuff, so I'm from it. Okay. I'm going to tell you guys about my workplaces tonight. I'm from New Hampshire. Is anyone else from New Hampshire?
No!
Nice. Nice. All right, that wasn't a lot of people. Is anyone from just outside of Boston? Okay. That's basically what living in New Hampshire is like. No, but I have two jobs. So one of my jobs is at the children's room of a public library. And the other job is at a small concert venue, the Hampton Beach Casino Ballroom, if anyone's ever been there. And two very different jobs. I mean, like, at the library, I have to clean up after incoherent children, and at the ballroom, I have to clean up after incoherent drunk people. You know what? They're not that different after all. But, the ballroom, I love it there. It's so great to work at a concert venue. We've gotten some great performers there. We got George Thorogood. And if you don't know who George Thorogood, he has a song in a Viagra commercial. It's Who Do You Love? It's like, dun, 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 who do you love? And I always thought that was a weird choice for a George Thorogood song to be in a Viagra commercial. Because I always thought the more appropriate one would be Back to the Bone. I'm glad you guys got that. If that didn't work, see, to make a scientific allusion, it would be two variables there, because I don't know if you guys didn't laugh because it was an ED joke, or if you guys didn't laugh because it was a George Thorogood joke. I don't know if you guys aren't laughing because I made a weird science joke, like, honestly. Okay, we get a lot of good bands. We also get some cover bands. So we got this Queen cover band. And so we have this guy up there pretending to be Freddie Mercury. And I was just like, that's really cool. But then I was thinking, what in this guy's life led him to the point where he was making money pretending to be Freddie Mercury? What happened? Like, what scenario happened in his life? Did he just was sitting there with his band one day and he was like, man, that gig sucked. Ugh. Another one bites the dust, I guess. Wait, Jake, say that again. Another one bites the dust. That's it. Grow a funny mustache and do this. They made a living out of it. One Night at Queen, if they come around, check them out. Plug the band that I'm not in. Hey, have you heard about this One Direction? They're pretty good. Try them. I don't know what that meant. Okay. So we got, at the ballroom, we got the Impractical Jokers there. Anyone watch that show?
Yeah!
And me neither. They did four shows in two nights, and that was a lot of work because we had to get 2,000 people in and out twice every night. So the show wasn't great, I'm going to be honest. It was okay, but the biggest entertainment we got was in between shows they would play All I Do Is Win. Like, was it DJ Khaled?
Yeah?
I always think it's T-Pain, so then I get messed up. I don't know my music at all. So, if you don't know the song All I Do Is Win, excuse me, I'm gonna sing again. It goes, all I do is win, 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 no matter what. Can't sing. No, got money in my mind, I can never get enough. Okay, you guys participate. And every time I step up in the building, everybody's hands go up. And they stay there. Okay, so I was singing that. So I was ushering and I was doing that. I would So everybody's hands go up, and anyone that was working, we would put our hands up. So one time I was doing it, and as everyone's hands go up, and I look over to my nearest coworker, and it's Corey, who has one arm, and he goes, I swear to God, it was a total accident. And I had to go over to him afterwards, be like, Corey, I'm so sorry. I was totally joking. I was just looking at the nearest person. I didn't mean to. And he was like, dude, it's fine. Like, whatever. And, oh my God. And I'm glad you guys laughed. I'm so glad you guys laughed, guys. Because I was like, are they going to laugh? Is it too offensive? But, you know. All right, guys. Thank you.